Aliwala.
A new thing which is under the church ministry.
Tugenda kwanjula ekitundutundu ky'omutwe ekirala naye nga tukyali wansi w'obuweereza obw'obunnabbi.
And now we are going to look at actually the prophet.
Kati tugenda kulaba nabbi obuweereza obw'obunnabbi.
We are going to look at the character of a prophet.
Era tugenda kulaba nabbi ono embala y'ebeetya.
How do we tell that actually this person is a prophet and the question of this person to show that he's a prophet?
Otegeera otya ky'omuntu ono nabbi era amala ki z'olina okutunuulira ow'okunoonya si kw'obaonoonya nabbi omutuufu?
First of all, I would say, maybe to note,
kisooka soka wandiika kino,
the true prophets,
nabbi omutuufu,
always appear in the times of apostasy,
ajja kulabika mu kiseera eky'okuyaayaana nga tewali Katonda.
It means people have drifted away from their faith.
Nga kitegeeza nti abantu bavudde mu kukkiriza.
People have gone to the idols.
Kitegeeza ng'abantu bavudde mu Katonda bagenze mu kusinza ebifaananyi.
It means the churches are no longer on track.
Nga kitegeeza ng'amakanisa gavudde ku mulamwa.
It means the nations have left their living God.
Nga kitegeeza nti amawanga gavudde ku Katonda omulamu.
And so God will raise the quality and the quality of prophets.
Katonda ajja kuyimusa nabbi ow'omutindo.
And the quality prophet who comes with substance.
Era nabbi ono ow'omutindo agenda kujja n'ekinusi.
Many people will be turning to the left.
Abantu bangi bajja kuba bakyuka.
They will be turning to the left. Turn to the left means you're
looking at the mukubo bagenze wakyamu.
And so the work of this prophet
era ng'omulimu gwa nabbi ono
is to bring back people from the left to the right.
Kwe kujja abantu mukubo ekyamu abazze mukubo egobekofu.
That is what we can say maybe to the prophets that appear in the time.
Nabbi atuuka mu kaseera k'abantu ng'abantu babula okuva ku Katonda.
And the witnesses that we can see is one of them is Elijah.
Era nga okyokulabirako ow'omujulizi omu ku bannabbi ono ye Eliya.
And another one was Jeremiah.
Omulala yali Yeremiya.
Jeremiah was raised for Babylonian confrontation.
Yeremiya mukama yamuyimusa asobole okulumba Babiloni.
And Elijah was raised against the nation of Israel, which was drifting off from the truth against the Baal prophets.
Neriya naye yayimusibwa mu kaseera ng'eggwanga lya Isirayiri livudde ku Katonda nga ligenze mu bakatonda ba Baali.
And so God always needs this prophet who can be able to turn his people away from
Katonda. Buliseeyagala nabbi ono asobole okukyusa abantu be abajje mu mulimba.
From deception, manipulation, divination.
Mukozesebwa bye batayagala kukozesebwa n'ebyokwerakuza nga bakozesa amaanyi g'ekizibu.
The way of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Abateeke mu kkubo lya Mukama waffe Yesu Kristo.
And Jeremiah of course will be raised.
Yeremiya ajja kuyimusibwa mu mbeera bw'etyo.
One to overthrow.
Kisooka kujjawo.
To destroy.
Ekyokubiri kuyonoona.
And also to plant.
Ekyokusatu kusimba.
But also to uproot.
Kyokka atera n'okusimbulula.
And also to build.
Atera n'okuzimba.
But who is this prophet? How do we know that this is the one?
Naye nabbi ono y'ani era otegeera otya nti oyo ddala ddala gwe baleese?
What I can say is,
kye nsobola okugamba kye kino.
True prophets will point to the church to the vision of God.
Nabbi omutuufu owa Katonda ajja kuwalula ekkanisa ng'agiraga ekifaananyi kya Katonda ekirungi oba ekituufu.
One, you bring a clear vision.
Ekisooka ajja kuleeta okwolesebwa okutuufu okwa Katonda.
He will demonstrate the wisdom of God.
Ajja kulaga amagezi, ajja kulaga oba okwolesa amagezi ga Katonda.
And you bring the perspective of God in a church.
Era ajja kuleeta ennono oba enjigiriza ez'obwa Katonda mu kanisa.
His work is to release the vision and the calling of the church.
Era omulimu gwe kwe kusumulula okwolesebwa n'ebirooto n'okuyitibwa kw'ekkanisa ya Kristo.
Minus the prophetic ministry.
Wabanga tewali muweereza bonna bwa bunnabbi.
There's no clear vision.
Tewali okwolesebwa kulambulukufu.
And therefore the prophet, this prophet we're talking about, we are not talking about the gift of prophecy.
Tewogera kuchiyako chakula kula puke ya kuna pi.
You know some of the Christians are quite sad. The rich woman said, do you see I sit every day in the church so I have the vision of the church?
Nyama loko lebali fane, nji, hainzo kuchu mkeboka, natani konga mbabali na loko, chua lama mkanisa zebanda wa chiyone chini, nesheleza na mkepina.
No, you will say that I have the vision of the church because I don't mind if I'm not there, they don't see. That is not what we are talking about. We are talking about the true prophets. The
prophecy
of the prophet. And so we are going to look at his characteristics. What makes him up?
Mbala chijamala eno emufula nabi.
How is he supposed, or how should, why should we call him a prophet? What should come out of him?
Mwati filo kumwita nabi. Yami chido msuri okuwa mbabi mufamu.
Should we call him a prophet just simply he tells us about the food we ate yesterday?
Tumwite nabi. Waka tumuli emele netuwalite guno.
Should we call him a prophet just because maybe he gives us what is going to happen on us?
Tumumuite nabi. Unokuwa wetuja maso gati muli emele kututukako.
And so there are some notable features or characteristics that we need to note out of this prophet. Because God will need the prophetic power to overturn things around.
Katonda, yeta gamanya kwa unabi, okuchuse mitu yonye mibelami acha ankalana.
Minus the prophetic power, there is nothing that is stand.
E watali, mani ga unabi, te wali chitucho na chita acha ankalana. Chiza kuchusi wali chitereze.
So that person we are talking about, that prophet that
God has told. Omutu wale watuonge lako, unabi oyu, amela ya iti kwa.
Sit in the office of the prophet. Not only revelation. We shall not cling to a prophet just because he has seen us eating food yesterday. Okay, we always want people to come to the prophets and then they tell us what you have done about our lives, maybe our past history. Those are the things that we want.
Tuangale nyo kucha, hawa nchile watula kulako, ebya fayo ya fe. Mwemi tumetua kole mwaweka, biemi tumetua kala mwemi tukubani.
No matter what the prophet is doing, even if he's raping, even if he's doing...
Sinsonga, mwana pyo ya kwata na wakazi, wanawe ya kwata, mwakastaba nga kula kula.
As long as he tells you, your future husband, or maybe your future wife...
Mchala wawo, mwani wasa, mwakazi wakwani wele na ye, mwani wawo.
That is not what we are looking for. Now you can note these things about the character of
prophet.
One is purity. Purity is first. God's standard of purity is quite high. And it does not just come easily. And so God will take many years preparing this
prophet
to make him the standard he wants. It was required by God Isaiah to be touched in the mouth.
Katonda, jamu tualia, okukwata Isaiah, na muteko mulio kululimire, asobolo kumulo omosa.
And you think it is very easy.
Mbolo omosa changu, okundilo mulio lewa kuteka mukamwa.
They got it from the burning incense.
Babu jamu mukolo,
the answer of God, yes.
Babu jamu choto chakatona.
Because they wanted to make him pure so that he can speak well for God.
You
see, God is not looking for people who can just speak. No. No, he's looking the people who can speak with his purity. Because the word without the purity of God, instead of blessing, it curses you. And that's That's why when you came from all those churches who were prophesying every day.
They
didn't have the character of purity. And therefore their word was turning into a curse instead they speak. It became poison into your life. A true prophet, a true prophet must be with purity of God. Let's read Isaiah 6 from 1-7.
Mwaka kabaka Uzziya mwe yafiira nalaba Mukama ng'atudde ku ntebe y'empanvu eyagulumizibwa n'ekirenge kye nga kijjula yeekaalu. Olwokubiri, baserafi baali bayimiridde waggulu we. Buli omu yalina ebiwaawaatiro mukaaga, ebibiri yabibikka ku maaso ge, n'ebibiri yabibikka ku bigere bye, n'ebibiri yabibuusa. Olwokusatu, omu n'ayogerera waggulu eri munne ng'agamba nti, mutukuvu, 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 Mukama w'eggye, ensi yonna ejjudde ekitiibwa kye. Olwokuna, n'emisingi gy'emiryango ne ginyeenyezebwa olw'eddoboozi ery'oyo eyayogerera waggulu, ennyumba n'ejjula omukka. Olwokutaano, ne ndyoka njogera nti, zinsanze kubanga nfudde, kubanga ndi muntu wa mimwa ekitali mirongoofu era ntuula wakati mu bantu ab'emimwa ekitali mirongoofu, kubanga amaaso gange galabye Kabaka Mukama ow'Eggye. Olw'omukaaga, omu ku baserafi n'alyoka abuuka n'ajja gye ndi ng'alina eryanda eryaka omuliro eryaka mu ngalo ze, ebyo lye yali ajje ku kyoto n'ennamagalo, n'alikomya ku kamwa kange n'ayogera nti, laba lino likomye ku mimwa gyo era obutali butuukirivu bwo bujjiddwawo n'ekibi kyo kirongoosebbwa.
God bless you. Now I'm at home. God to get a call that was burning so much.
Tatuwa katonda, okugenda mu kyoto kye, najamu eryanda eryali likutte ennyo nga lyaka omuliro.
So you can see how seriously he's about purity.
Ndozolaba katonda bwali omwesimbu ennyo ku nsonga y'obulongoofu.
But the prophet of today, he wants to be in the Lord today.
Isaiah yatukuzibwa mu kibi mu maaso ga Katonda.
He even said, I have seen the Lord.
Nagamba ndabye Mukama.
I'm unclean. He accepted that he was a sinner.
Ni mwononi.
And so God saw that he needed to be purged out to work for him.
Katonda n'ategeera nti Isaiah ono yali alina okulongoosebwa asobole okumukolera by'ayagala.
And so you can see that the purity
obulongoofu Katonda bw'ayagala olwannabbi,
it is very high.
Wa kika kya waggulu.
If it needs to get the fire from somewhere of God,
bwe kiba kyetaagisa kufuna muliro wonna gwakucyanga gwokya nnyonnyonnyo, asobole okukulongoosa okukikola ajja kukikola. Naye ate naawe ng'omuntu olina omulimu ogw'okukola, olina okukuuma obulongoofu Katonda bw'abeera
kuwaddeera.
Awo bwe tutyo bwe tunuulira obulamu bwaffe obw'okusaba.
God requires a prophet of purity.
Katonda asuubira nnabbi okuba nga mul and
a high standard of purity
in order to become this
spokesperson. Isaiah was purged before he could speak for God. Now, if you see this prophet who just moves around with Rugambo, with doing everything, just know.
Whatever Nabi, but when Nabi Azunga Zunga, Napolo Rugambo, Napole, it means in Yemi Ambione.
He's not pure, he cannot, his word cannot.
Manyasimulongo Fu, Eshgamboche, the chins of Kulokola.
The men of God are silent in the desert.
Abasadia Makatonda.
Defending the blood of Jesus Christ. Keeping the purity for the church. Keeping the standard of God in the
church.
Not seeking how to give a man, a boy to a man. That's not the word of the prophet.
Sila mikunoneza musajja. Mukazi, kwa mukazi musajja. Ili mimusija nabi, ili mimusija wakola.
What he needs is to fuel the purity in the church.
Nabi chali wakukula, kwekundi ya muna ulogo fuwa mchula. Nila mjuse kanisa.
Let me tell you, if you're the prophet or if you're the head.
Singo mtuwe, wakani nabi ono.
It's not pure.
Nasimu lomofu.
You can't have purity in this church.
Tosula kwela na mlongo ofu mukanisa.
And you can't even have a fear of the Lord in the church.
Tosula na kumba na kuchangwa katona.
Because the fear of the Lord makes us always to come to do purity.
Kumbaga, okuchangwa katona, ukuletelo kutani kongola, ibintu byo mlongo ofu.
So in most cases, men and prophets,
Muisele misinga, panabibaji,
are not pure by the fact of what they are doing.
Siwa mlongo ofu, kulen songa,
and so purity is one of the characteristics that is needed first in a prophet. It is needed in the life of the prophet to fuel the vision of God.
Because God is saying
who is going to go for us.
And he's
preparing you so that you may reach his vision everywhere. The vision of the prophet is not the vision of himself. It is the vision of God. It is not the intention, it is not what he wants to achieve. And therefore, if you are carrying the vision of God, you have to maintain and bear purity in your life. Number two is discipline. Discipline is the reason why God takes many times, long time, passing you through the desert. That you may be a disciplined prophet. An obedient prophet. A humble prophet. And that training, it will cultivate so many things that we're going to look at. The reason is that God wants to cultivate a high level of discipline in prophets.
One, accept
his advice.
Two,
accept his direction. The problem is that most prophets are stubborn. And sometimes they want no more than God. sometimes he has to raise the pastor who is hurt. No, he brings a pastor who is hard for the prophets.
Katonda, aleta omusumba, gaiyato omusumba, mugumu nyo 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 nyo, okusinga nabiyoyo, asobole, okuleti la mwini nabiyoyo, empisa za yagala.
The reason is to displease them.
Enzo gano chetu katonda chikola, haba yagala nabiyoyo, na yawe erene empisa.
That's the way that the faith,
basobole okufuna empisa.
That fruit.
Bakune chino la chino, echo kumera nempisa.
Of care, of being telling that
you are
dream. So in Moses is the prophet,
Naifat the church.
And so for that reason, God takes much time being hard on
them.
To obtain that level of obedience. To obtain that level of humility. So we cannot and say that sometimes most prophets are stubborn and they don't have any discipline. You tell them to keep quiet, they continue. They want to show that they are wrong. They want to show that they have a different spirit that works in them than
they
have. And so in that case, they lack no direction and discipline. And so God sometimes he raises a pastor who can be hard on them to discipline them. But the reason why God does that is that
he
wants to deal with ego and also pride in their life. And so he's always dealing with them and being hard and harsh on them to produce the fruit of this spirit that God wants. So the prophet is going to be taught in a world which is rude so much. You want to push a boy, a woman, you're pregnant, you want to push a boy, then they say, baby, pushy. No, the boy won't come out, he might die. So what they do, they have to do a lot of many things until they push that boy out. And that is what we call a rude world. And so many prophets, they find themselves on the other side of the Lord. And so God to turn them around, to put them on the right track. He has to discipline them.
I know what they come with this.
And one, he can take them to the desert.
I saw no what you are going to do.
With situations. He can humiliate them by giving a false prophecy. The reason is that he's dealing with your ego and pride in you.
And you don't know it, Kola.
And in such, his church cannot be edified.
Kati, mumbera wezicho, hawela, ayakale kanisa ye, nisobro kukulumisi.
God deals with them in a rude world.
Kati, umdakule na mo, mungeri,
to humble themselves. And humility is part of that discipline that is going out.
Iranga, mukubaisa mumelele enkakali, obuombe kunomukakamu, chechimala chebajayo.
Jeremiah had a problem.
Yeremiah ono yalina obuzibu bunene.
He was also a stubborn prophet.
Yeremiah yali nabbi, nega nebyalu.
And so God wanted to display him.
Katonda nayagala amutekemu
empisa. He put him in the people where they would humiliate him.
Yamuteka mu bantu ng'abantu bamusekerera.
To destroy ego out of him.
And
Jeremiah started complaining to God. This is what God replied to him. Let's read there.
Oli mutuukirivu ayi Mukama, bwe mpoza naawe era nandibadde ne kyenkunnyonnyolako ekkubo ery'ababi lirabira muki omukisa. Nziramu olusooka. Oli mutuukirivu ayi Mukama, bwe mpoza naawe naye era nandibadde ne kyenkunnyonnyolako ekkubo ery'ababi lirabira ki omukisa. Abateleera kiki oba bonna abalimbalimba ennyo wabasimba weewaawo basimbye emmizi bamera weewaawo babala ebibala oli kumpi mu kamwa kaabwe oli wala n'emmeeme yaabwe olwokusatu naye gwe ayi Mukama omanyi ondaba n'okema omutima gwange bwe gufaanana gy'oli basike ng'endiga ez'okusalibwa obategekere olunaku olw'okuttirwako olw'okuna ensi erituusaawa okuubaala n'emiddo gy'omu nsi yonna negiwotoka olw'obubi bwabo abagirimu ensolo kyeziva zimalibwawo n'ennyonyi kubanga bayogera nti taliraba nkomerero yaffe ya luvannyuma. Olw'okutaano oba ng'oddukidde wamu n'abatambula n'ebigere ne bakukoyesa kale oyinza otya okuwakana n'embalaasi era newankubadde nga weegolodde mu nsi ey'emirembe naye olikola otya mu malala ga Yordaani.
God bless you. Let me read number 5. He said, but God loved these people. Why are they prospering even?
Lwaki n'okulaakulana bakulaakulana?
They should die, they should prepare the day. Now, Jeremiah's there was, you know, he was almost looking for vengeance on the enemies around him. But he does know that God was trying to discipline him. And you see how he replied to him. If you have run with foot men and they have worried you, how can you contend with the horses? And also say, they worried you then, how will you do in the flood plain of Jordan? Now, he expects Jeremiah to have a certain standard.
Aina omutindo oba ekigera kya suya Yeremia ekyokugumikiriza kyalina okubeerako.
And he's disciplining him so that he may face these situations and come out as a true prophet.
Aliko amuteekateeka asobole okusisinkana embeera zino asobole okuviirayo ddala nga nabbi omutuufu owa katonda naye yaliko agamba katonda nedda bijewo mbikoye ebiseera ebisinga katonda agenda kukuleetera abantu abakyamu bonna babeera kwetolooza asobole okussaamu empisa ze asobole okufunamu ekibala naye omuzi muli nti abantu abo bwabakuleetera mu bulamu bwo tutwala ddala kubuuza katonda naye katonda omuntu gundi ne gundi lwaki ali
wanolwaki
akola bwati ne
bwati
oba oli awo olina embala enkyamu katonda gyagala
okukyamu
oba olina embala enkyamu katonda ajja kuteeka mu bantu abalina embala enkyamu okusinga asobole nawe
gikujaera
bajja kusomoza okutuusa ng'otuusa mu kigero ekyo katonda kyayagala obeera otuukeko
If you see a prophet not having any discipline,
era bona banabbi yenna nga talina mpisa,
he does not respect people,
tasaamu bantu kitiibwa,
he does not respect the people of God,
tasaamu bantu ba Katonda kitiibwa,
just know that God has not dealt with that person.
Manya Katonda tanaba kumusisinkana.
Oh, he has never received the call of God.
Nga tafunanga kuyitibwa kwa Katonda.
But those who are humble in nature,
nawo waliwo abo abakakamu mu mbeera zaabwe.
So they would not need to be taught in a rude world.
Tebajja kwagala basomesebwe mu mbalambi.
And so God will teach them with nice people.
Katonda ajja basomesa n'abantu abalala abalungi.
So do you want to be like Jeremiah to run with the horses or you want to run with men?
Oyagala kuduka n'abantu oba oyagala kuduka n'embalaasi.
Because the standard of a horse
kubanga embiro z'embalaasi
yotekoowa
edukira ddala ku mbiro
otambula
nayo okufaano n'otuuka ebalala nga
tekooye
ngate waliwo amakubo agamu katonda gakutegekedde nga bwe gatyo bwe gali asobole okutereeza akuteeke mu kkubo ettuufu era bw'olemererwa mu mbiro bwezityo okufunamu empisa tolitikkirwa kufuuka nabbi
Maybe we can also look at Jeremiah 16:1-6.
Katugende mu Yeremia 16:1 paka ku lunyiriri olw'omukaaga.
Towasanga mukazi so tozaalira baana ba bulenzi newankubadde ab'obuwala mu kifo kino. Kubanga Mukama bw'ayogera bw'ati eby'abaana ab'obulenzi n'ab'obuwala abazaalibwa mu kifo kino n'ebyabannyaabwe ababazaala n'ebyabakitaabwe ababazaalira mu nsi muno olw'okuna nti balifa bubi tebalikungubagirwa so tebaliziikirwa balibanga obusa ku maaso g'ettaka era balimalibwawo n'ekitala n'enjala n'emirambo gyabwe giriba mmere ya nnyonyi ez'omu bbanga era ensolo ez'omu nsiko kubanga bwati bw'ayogera Mukama nti toyingira mu nnyumba mwe bakungubagira so togenda kukaaba biwoobe so tobakaabira kubanga nyiize emirembe gyange ku bantu bano bw'ayogera Mukama mbaggyeko ekisa n'okusaasira okulungi
Okay, God bless you.
Abakungubaga n'abakungubagirako n'abaziikirako.
And some of these things were not right before God.
Kyokka ng'ebintu bye bambi bye yakolanga tebyali nga bituufu mu maaso ga
Katonda.
N'amugamba Ssemu Yeremia towasanga mu kitundu kino.
Now we can see that part of this discipline that he wanted was to be obedient.
Olaba empisa gye yali ayagala okumu kolamu kwe kubera omugonvu.
And so Jeremiah was taught in the midst of the wicked people.
Era Yeremia yasomesebwa mu masekati g'abantu abaali abagogonyufu.
Obtain this meaning on how to trust God.
Asobola okufuna empisa ey'okwesiga Katonda.
And so a prophet's life
olamu kwa nabbi wonna
must be well disciplined.
Bulina okuba nga bulimu empisa.
In order to serve God well.
Asobola okuweereza obulungi Katonda.
And the people surrounding him.
N'abantu abamwetoolodde abasobola okubaweereza.
Those God he has put in charge of him.
N'abo abantu Katonda baamutaddeko okuba ng'avunaanyizibwa.
He must be a good example, a great example of discipline.
Ateekeddwa okubeera ekyokulabirako ekirungi eky'empisa.
One of them was Moses.
Era omu ku bo yali Musa.
And Daniel. Those are the ones that I can know they were so much displayed before God.
Omukubo yali Musa ne Danieli erabo bebali abempisa ennyo mu maaso ga Katonda.
So the prophetic life or the character of a prophet
obulamu bwa nnabbi obembala ya nnabbi
must never be unbending. Unbending like it shouldn't be fixed in one place.
Kiteekeddwa okubeera ng'eri mu kifo kimuti abeera bwati ne bwati.
So sometimes God may give you an instruction but then he changes it when he wants something.
Katonda abiriza okukuwa ekiragiro n'otambula nakyo n'atuuka eyo mu maaso n'akuwa ekiragiro ate nga kikyusa kiri kye yakuwa ekyasooka.
So it is God who can change the instructions of the prophets, not the people.
Katonda yakyusa ebiragiro si bantu be bakukyusiza. Katonda yakyusiza nabbi ebiragiro bye.
So the prophet's office will take much learning.
Yapesia nabbi ebamu okuyiga kungi.
It takes the path of toil.
Ebamu okuntulugunyizibwa olw'ebizibu bingi.
In gathering experience on how to lead the people of God.
Mu ngeri y'omuntu okufunamu obukugu obw'okukulembera abantu ba Katonda.
So in that kind of manner.
Mu mbeera bw'etyo.
The prophetic ministry requires discipline to get successful in the prophetic ministry. The prophetic office
yapesia nabbi
requires high discipline.
Yetaga empisa ezekika ekyawaggulu
to be successful in the prophetic ministry.
Esobola okubeera empanguzi mu buweereza obw'obunabbi.
So if you see any prophets out there
era bw'olaba nabbi yenna ebweru eyo
and is not disciplined, he just speaks anyhow
nga talina mpisa byasanga byayogere yayogereranga bw'ayagala.
He does not treat people well. He does not care.
Tabayisa bulungi era tabakwako.
He does not listen.
Nga tawuliriza.
He's not obedient. He's not humble.
Nga simu kakamu.
It means he's not a disciplined prophet.
Kitegeeza nti si nabbi ow'empisa.
And even here in the church.
Ne wano mu kanisa.
Let me not talk about outside.
Tetwogera wabwebwe.
If you're here and then you have that call of a prophet or maybe the gift of seeing.
Era bw'oli wano mw'olina ekirabo kya nabbi oba ekirabo ekyo ekyokulaba.
And you cannot respect.
Nga tosobola kusaamu kitiibwa.
You cannot be disciplined in the way you're handling things.
Nga tosobola kusiwamu mpisa mu ngeri gy'okolamu mirimu gyo.
We are likely to start doubting you either it is just that they're using you or it is not. The Holy Spirit.
Tujja kukomekereza nga tukubusabusa nga tugamba oyinza okuba nga Yezebeli yakozesa nga si mwoyo.
Kubanga
kintu kimu wano kye tulaba ku bulamu bwa nabbi. Okuyita mu bulamu bw'okutegeera nabbi. Nabbi omwoyo omutukuvu akuyigiriza empisa za kika kya waggulu.
Be patient.
Ne bwaba kugamba kumikiriza.
You must be disciplined to respect the action or what has been said on you.
Oteekeddwa okubeera okumikiriza n'okumikiriza ekyo ekibeera kikugambiddwa.
So you must be a listener of instructions.
Olina okubeera ng'owuliriza nnyo ebiragiro.
If you have a great vision and have refused it.
Bw'oba ng'olina okwolesebwa okunene nga kugambiddwa.
Do not go there. I had a vision from God. It was directed from the chair. I just saw him from his throne. And
people
are refusing the vision.
Togera maso. No, no, no. Kukakata kubati. No gamba. No gamba. Zenafunye.
pastor does not accept it. But this is the work of God. This is just called me. I'm telling you, one of the things that you need to know is as a character that God expects of you is discipline. You must be a good listener to the leaders. You must be well aligned in association of the leadership. Otherwise, you'll be taking prophecies from Jezebel. Because lack of discipline leads us to the open gate of the devil.
Kubanga empisa wezi kubula obera okukumba ngogende yezisa stani zabela kubuletewo.
I pray that God gives you a grace.
Nsaba Katonda abawechi sa.
For today we shall stop here, but
walero tugenda komawo.
We are still looking at the character of our prophet.
Ne tuchalaba embala ya nabi.
God bless you.
Naliwala.
Hallelujah! Yeah, last Sunday we are still looking at the prophetic ministry. And we saw from the beginning that without the prophetic ministry, we are all retarded in all our ministry. And so, with prophetic ministry, we are able to get back our vision and calling from God. So last Sunday, we are looking at the sub-theme of a character of a prophet. And we now saw that the true prophets always appear in the days of apostasy. When people have shifted away from the right way of God, when the nations have deviated from the truth, when the kings, when the priests of the land have gone out of the way. Now, that is when God plans to prepare a prophet for and he raises this prophet to turn back the hearts of the people. And so, in this era, we are filled with so many false prophets. And so somebody might say, those are the ones that God is raising to. No, not a believer. Maybe somebody who doesn't know might think these are the right prophets God has brought to turn the hearts of the people to God. And so with that, so many people are murdered and they are laid away from the truth. So yearning for prophecies has brought a deviation or deception in the church. Beginning from the presidents, the kings of the land, and also the Christians. And we have to understand why God has brought the prophet ministry to the church. And so, but we see when we go to the scriptures, that's where we can find the purpose why God called a prophet. And so we see that this prophet of God must always carry the heart and the body of the Lord. And so his race not carry the feelings of the people, but to take the thoughts of God. And so his work is in fact the most powerful of the prophet that God has called is carry the burden of the Lord and the heart of God.
It's
not what is in the heart of the Lord to give it to the church. And this kind of a prophet
will
be a quality prophet and
will
be quality, I mean, of substance. And such a prophet will serve God for a long time. The problem is that the people around the world, the entire world, they have been devastated. And most of them have been maybe offended so many times in their lives. And so you realize that their feelings, they always want to hear what they want to hear, not what they need to hear. Yeah, each time we expect highly, and you don't get, you get disappointed. But the problem is that now people are not grounded to manage the disappointment. Now you realize that now the people, they'll be filled with the disappointment, and now they will leave the way of God. So they will seek solutions from different places. Now when you find a disappointed Christian, you might think maybe, let me say, if you're a prophet, but you might not know even where this disappointment came from. But because maybe you see him sick, maybe you see him having something. Now you say, now the Lord says, that be firm, you will get the house that you need. Now you have spoken not from the heart of God. You have not known where the person has come from. And so you have not carried the heart of God. You have based your prophecy upon us, the feeling of a person. Maybe you're basing your prophecy depending on what you're seeing with a person. Maybe you see it's frustrated, but you have not known what caused that frustration. And so you make, because you want to give him hope, and you say, thus says the Lord, he will give you life, he will give you all the riches in this world. Now, because this person has been devastated, now you open up the conscience of hoping more again. But you don't know, is that the word that really God wanted to speak at that time? And so we are looking at the character of a prophet. How should the prophet live? Is he supposed to look at the people and their situation and then he prophesies
it?
We have some of the prophets that God had raised. And we see Jeremiah. We see Elijah. And these are the people that were raised in the place of apostles. And of course Jezebel had taken over the entire Israel. And there were so many Baal prophets in that era. And so you realize that God raised Elijah against Ahab. because of Jezebel who had taken over the house of
Ahab.
But then you see Jeremiah being raised during the days of the priests, the kings, they are taken, they are gone, they are gone out from the way of God. And what are we saying? That the prophet is not supposed to be raised to please the people. The true point of the prophet is
he's
supposed to point the vision of the church to realize the God's kingdom on earth. To realize God's kingdom on earth. And so
he's
supposed to bring a clear vision and the insight of God's wisdom to the church. And so the prophetic ministry will bring that perspective, the God's perspective within the church. And it releases a vision and the calling of God in the church.
So
those are the kind of the prophets we are looking for. We are looking for prophets who are bringing God's perspective in the church, not man's perspective in the church. And so with that standard, we expect some particular character within those prophets. One is purity. God's standard of purity is very high. And so our movement of when we want to walk with God, we must find His standard. It is not God looking for your standard, but it is God
looking for.
And so the purity is quite high that is needed in the
prophet.
And so God will take so many years to prepare this prophet to obtain the high standard of and also the righteousness of God. And so to make him ready,
to be
very specific, is that when we come to Jesus Christ, all of us, we are sinners before Christ. But then, for Him to use us,